Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is the narrator Ravi Gupta. Today we gonna talk about CO2 properties. Okay. After that we'll see how the CO2 causes toxicity, and then we'll see what are general inspection we are going to carry out in a CO2 fire installation. And through a series of diagram I will show you what we are going to check, and then we're going to talk about that how we are going to release the CO2 in SIP. And after that I will tell you how, what action you should take after the CO2 is released and how the re-entry has been carried out. So please remain tuned Alash. This is a very important topic which is asked in MEO class 2, MEO class 4 for written and oral purposes. So in a synopsis I will tell you that CO2 basically fight the fire by smothering action. How? CO2 basically is heavier than air 1.4 time, and hence it reduces the oxygen to a point that where the combustion cannot occur. Okay. CO2 is installed in a sieve and it can be applied to the area in bulk quantity, such as engine room, cargo hold, purifier room, pump room in the fire scenario. How the CO2 is released, I hope I have told a lot of time. You can watch the video on CO2 fixed fire installation part 1. There I have explained the whole system. I will just read it out quickly. This bottle contains CO2 in liquid state. When the fire in the protected space goes out of control, or in a situation when the fire is not able to be extinguished by the local firefighting media, CO2 flooding system come into picture. Then when the CO2 will be used, that we are telling. CO2 from bottle directed via common manifold, main valve and distribution pipe to a nozzle, through which it is released to a protected space for fire extinction. Due to safety reason, CO2 flooding system is manually released from a release cabinet located outside the protected space. So very important point it is telling, that CO2 is manually released. Okay, why? So that to ensure that it cannot be operated in an emergency. Now, the very important point, what are the properties of CO2? These are asked in MEO class 4. Okay. Density of the CO2 is 1.5 times higher than the air. So CO2 settles down and displaces air, and hence it performs smoothing action. CO2 can be easily liquefied and bottled. Very good. 20 to 30% CO2 concentration extinguishes fire by smoothing action. Okay. Means if an air consisting of 20 to 30% of CO2, it can extinguish the fire by smoothing action. Means as the CO2 is heavier than air, it will settle down and it will form a blanket over the ignition equipment and prevent the fire to suffice. It is non-corrosive in nature, non-conductor of electricity, no radius left after application. These are the very important points. Means therefore, the CO2 system are preferred because it is non-corrosive, it is not a good conductor of electricity, and it left no residue, and the cleaning operation is very easy after application. No deterioration with age. Means if it is once installed, it can be kept for a lifelong period by carrying out the periodic inspection and survey. Similarly, there are some disadvantages. These are advantages of CO2. Now some disadvantages, such as CO2 is highly aspirating. 9% concentration causes unconsciousness within minute. Means the CO2 is very dangerous and toxic, because 9% of concentration of the CO2 in the air can cause unconsciousness for a personal in within a minute. Okay. Second, it has a very little cooling effect. CO2 only able to extinguish fire by smothering action. Otherwise, the foam, which is also a secondary means of fighting the fire, extinguishes the fire by smothering as well as by cooling action. So, as it has a very little cooling effect, it will have a danger of reignition. When discharged, solid CO2 particle present and generate sufficient static electricity to produce spark, and therefore the CO2 lines should be properly grounded. That is a very important point. Okay. Now, through a diagram, I want to show you that if the CO2 concentration is increased, then what will happen? Okay. Now, if the CO2 concentration is 8%, then the site will be getting blurred. If the CO2 is 3%, then there will be reduction in hearing as it is heavier than air, therefore it will reduce the sound wave travel. So through a brain, it will cause drowsiness if it is 1%. If it is 3%, it will cause mild narcosis. If it is 5%, it will cause dizziness, confusion, headache. And these are the reason why the CO2 is very dangerous in air if it is more than the specific amount. Secondly, it will cause sweating. Heart rate will be increased and the blood pressure will be increased. Shortness of breath will occur and muscular tremor will occur. So these are all the symptoms of the CO2 toxicity which will occur depending upon the percentage of the CO2 in the system. Okay. Now once we are going for a normal inspection, what we should see in a CO2 room? So we should check the emergency light and all other light which are fitted in the CO2 room, that is working fine or not. We should check the exhaust fan and ventilation. In exhaust fan, we should check the suction. The CO2 suction in the exhaust fan is from bottom and it should perform 6 air changes in a particular area for a particular minute. Means for particular 6 air changes should it carried out for a particular time period, and hence it should be checked. Check all bottle over all condition, clamp, valves. Means basically we will carry out the visual inspection. We'll check the operating wire condition, means the wire which are going to puncture. We'll check that for any wire breakage or any wire getting stranded, something. We'll check CO2 alarm, means we will just open the cabinet door. We'll check whether the alarm is coming or not. CO2 room key should be in position. Okay. Means key is provided in a CO2 room so that it can be operated. The pilot can be operated. Check the operating instruction. Inspection to be recorded in logbook and Saturday safety routine book. So these are all the things you should check in a CO2 system. Now, as you can see, this is the lock pin which has been provided. It should be when the CO2 system is not in operation or when the CO2 is been transported, this lock pin is placed so that it prevents the puncturing of the CO2 accidentally. Okay. And this is the pilot cylinder bottle, each individual consisting having a capability to puncture the bulk CO2 system. Okay. Now, as you can see, there's the different lines are provided and different means are provided from where the thing will be injected. Now, what are the procedure for releasing a CO2 to the engine room on ship? So before the CO2 should be released, the first and foremost thing you should tell the surveyor or to a exam you should write, muster at the muster station and take the head count. Before, we should take the head count to ensure that each and every personnel is in the muster station. Now, after that, master along with the approval of chief engineer take decision depending upon the situation that they will inject CO2 in the particular area or not. Okay. Now, master will give the approval, but the decision of CO2 and the operation will be carried by chief engineer. Okay. The nearest Coast Guard regulatory body and port authority to be informed and make sure that engine room space is fully closed, all door properly locked. Means suppose if we are injecting to engine room space or any other space, cargo space, the space should be properly sealed so that to have a maximum efficiency. And for that reason, it should be properly sealed. I mean to say that. The ship should be stopped, the weather should be good, means all these conditions should be checked, port authority should be informed. Now, make sure emergency generator is running on load, very important point, because we will blackout, means not blackout, we will close the main generator and we will ensure that the no running component should be there in the engine room, because we prevent the chances of getting fire or static electricity, all that, okay. Power is required for running emergency fire pump for boundary cooling. Why? Now the second question comes to mind. Why generator power we need? Because as the cooling effect of the CO2 is very less, therefore we will carry out the boundary cooling along with the CO2 injection so that to ensure the system get cool very quickly. All access door, vent flap, blower flap, skylight, hatches, flap to be closed. Means all the opening, all the air outlet openings should be properly closed. Quick closing valve to be operated from the fire control station. Okay, so till now what we have done, we have taken the headcount, all personnel is there. After the master approval, chief engineer will take decision. Okay, set the line. In the meantime, the bridge will inform the local authority bodies, and the area where it's going to be applied should be properly sealed. All the flaps, all the blowers, all the things should be closed. Okay, and after that, we'll operate the quick closing valve so that all the fire, all the fuel related thing, all the oil related thing valve is operated and all everything is closed. After that, we will operate the emergency switch, which will close the lube oil pump, fuel oil pump, everything. Okay, now all machinery in the engine should be stopped. Okay, after operating ES1, ES2, emergency switch 1, 2, all things will be stopped. All personnel should be vacated the engine room, means after taking the headcount, we are double confirming that, okay, all person have vacated the engine room. Now, CO2 must be released by the competent engineers, very important, means CO2 should be released by the chief engineer or vice engineer by the order of the master. Break the glass and take out the key from the CO2 pilot cylinder cabinet from the key box. Using the local CO2 pilot cylinder cabinet is preferred. Means whenever we are injecting the CO2, we prefer that the CO2 injection will take place from the CO2 room only, so that we can see all the operation, we can see the whether puncturing all the valve, means all the bulb puncturing of CO2 is taking place or not. Okay, open the pilot cylinder cabinet, audio visual alarm will sound and ventilation blower will triple activate. Okay, set up the line in the master valve, Neumann valve and section valve. Means basically we are mustering a particular area, we are operating the quick closing valve so that to ensure every fuel is line closed. After that, through emergency stop, we are closing everything. Now we will open the cabinet door. As the door is open, now alarm will go on and we will open the CO2, this CO2 bottle fire cylinder, and it will show the cylinder pressure and the CO2 will go and will puncture the bulk quantity amount of thing. But before operating the CO2 fire cylinder, we should align the particular area section valve, master valve, to ensure that CO2 will go to a particular area and all other valves are closed. Right now, you are seeing this engine room, pump room, cargo space area, means various valves are provided. So all other valves should be in closed position and the particular valve which should where the CO2 need to be operated should be open. These are all pneumatically operated. Okay, now set up the line, that is the master valve, Neumann valve, section valve. In CO2 pilot cabinet, open the pilot cylinder first. This will initiate CO2 activation followed by a time delay of 60 to 90 seconds, as you all know now. Now the system pressure can be checked from the pressure gauge on the manifold. Okay, after the valve is open or the pilot cylinder, a CO2 will go and will puncture this bulk CO2 system, and the pressure can be seen in the manifold here, the manifold, and then through a particular section the CO2 will go and will extinguish the fire. Okay, now we have released the CO2, but before that I want to also tell you that one, at the starting we are doing the head count. And before operating the pilot cylinder, we'll again do the head count. Means two time head count is generally carried out before CO2 release, to double sure that. Now CO2 has been released. Okay. Now what action we are going to do after that? So CO2 extinguishes fire by smoothing action. CO2 has a very little cooling effect. So there is a danger of reignition of fire when the engine room is ventilated immediately. Therefore, we are using the boundary cooling to reduce the engine room temperature so that the chances of reignition can be avoided. Ventilation of engine room should not be started until it has been ensured that the fire has been extinguished. Otherwise, the admission of air will aggravate the fire and causes reignition. This is done by monitoring the surrounding temperatures. Okay, so now you have, it means release the CO2. Now you are doing the boundary cooling. We will monitor the temperature of boundary cooling. Okay, it was for earlier 80 degree, now it is 30 degree, 20 degree. When it has reduced to a temperature of 20-25 degree, after that we will monitor the bulkhead temperature and we will ensure, okay, this temperature degree has come. Now we will perform a open the engine room ventilation. engine room to be sufficiently ventilated before entering. Okay, now we will ventilate the engine room. Two personnel wearing the breathing apparatus will carry out the entry with a constant communication with the bridge to ensure that there is no secondary fire. Now, after the engine room ventilation, sufficient ventilation, and ensuring there is to ensure that there is no secondary fire or there is no any fire sources there, two personnel wearing SCABA unit having a fire water jet wall will enter to a particular area and will inspect and will have a constant communication with the bridge to ensure that no secondary fire is there in engine room. Okay. In order to allow person to get away quickly and safely in case of fire, entrance and exit shall be kept clear. Very important. Backup team or support team to be ready in case of any difficulty in the site. It means that the emergency team to rescue the personnel which are going inside and a first aid team should be in a standby to ensure that the person who are carrying out the inspection doesn't get injured. After carrying out the inspection, time to be given to ensure that engine room is sufficiently ventilated for enough period of time. Okay, means we will carry out the inspection, now we will come out and we will again give a sufficient time so that to ensure that the engine room is sufficiently ventilated. We will ensure that there is no more hot spots, combustible material is there in the engine room atmosphere, and start the ventilation fan and bring the atmosphere to normal value. So one thing I want to tell you that after seeing that the boundary temperature has fallen below limit, we will not start the ventilation fan. We will do the natural ventilation after the personal entry and confirming there is no secondary fire. After they come out, when they confirm there is no secondary fire, then we will start the ventilation fan to ensure the full ventilation. And then after that, after a period of time, with the help of a toximeter, with the help of a oxygen analyzer, we'll see how much amount of CO2, how much amount of other gases, how much amount of oxygen are present in the engine room atmosphere before making the final entry. When it is above the, when the oxygen is 20.9% in all the level, in all different level, then only, and ensuring there is no secondary fire, then only we will do the perform the entry. Carry out, after performing the entry, we'll carry out the thorough inspection of engine room component and the other machinery. We'll assess the damage and depending upon the scenario, bring the engine to normal working condition after performing the necessary action. Means after that, when we have done the entry, now we will start the generator. We will bring the power back to the system. We will check the other system. We will perform cleaning action. We will inspect the engine room. We will carry out the crankshaft deflection. We will rotate the engine freely. Check the power of free rotation. We will have to do different things. Means we have to perform a thorough inspection of engine room component, generators and everything. When we ensure that there is no damage after performing a cleaning action, we will restore the thing to a normal scenario. Okay. So, now, CO2 flooding is the final course of action. Very important. You should know that CO2 is the final course of action and it should be only used when all the means of extinguishing the fire has been failed. Proper sealing is very important. And second thing, to obtain total flooding in engine room, about 30% by volume of CO2 is required in 2 minutes. This will be reduced the oxygen content of the air in the engine room to less than 15% to extinguish the fire. At this, CO2 concentration human cannot be supported. So basically, what I mean to say that CO2 is injected 85% of its total amount in a period of 2 minutes, or you can say 35% of its volume including the casing inside the engine room space in a period of 2 minutes, so that it can increase its concentration to a level of 15% in the air to extinguish the fire in engine room space. Typically, it takes 15 to 20 seconds after the CO2 before the concentration in engine room reaches the dangerous level. Okay. So, I hope now you have understand that how the CO2 system work and how we are going to release CO2 and how we are going to perform the entry after CO2 release. If you have any doubt, please do comment below and please do subscribe and please do hit the bell icon. Marine Engineering Hub is a very important platform for sharing knowledge. Please do share this information in your Facebook account, WhatsApp account, Instagram account, and please bring marine personnel to this platform so that we can learn and grow together. And a request to all of you, I'm making a video with very lot of courage. I need support from all of you. If you want to read this article, you can go to marinelesson.com. It's also a site of Marine Engineering Hub, where you will find both the video and both the written form, and you can learn it from there. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.